Okay, now we're up to 1.4. Other Twitter features. Let's have a look at hashtags, trends, search functionality, and direct messages. Okay, so I'm hoping this page is looking familiar to you. Once again, we're on the Twitter homepage. You can tell by the underline being under the home on the top left navigation bar. So I'm going to go through a couple of Twitter's main features. Hashtags will be the first, so let's have a look at those. So what is a hashtag exactly? A hashtag is a symbol and it's used to mark keywords or topics that basically categorize your tweet. So if we have a look in my news feed right here, as you can see, the first one that is in sight is Virgos. So this is a Twitter account dedicated to Virgos. And as you can see, with the hashtag Virgos, they have categorized their tweet into being relevant to the word Virgos. Now, what you can actually do is these hashtags are interactive. You can click on this and find all other relevant content on Twitter about Virgos. As you can see, it's filed by top, so the top user accounts are showing up, and it's showing me all the most recent tweets and people that have been tweeting or talking about Virgos. And what you need to understand is that any word can be a hashtag. There are no rules. You throw a hash or the pound key at the front of any word and you've created a hashtag. Here is quote. Here is commitment. Once again, you click hashtag commitment and you will get all the hashtag commitment tweets and content around Twitter. So a couple of quick characteristics of hashtags. They can occur anywhere in the tweet. They can be at the start, at the end, like this one up here. There are no rules with hashtags. Later on in this video course, I'll give you tweet structure suggestions, but just know there are no hard and fast rules of where you should or should not put your hashtags. Only just keep them to a minimum of one or two per tweet, otherwise it's going to become a little bit more spammy. Popular hashtags become trending topics, which is our second feature we want to talk about. As you can see here on the left-hand side, trends. Now you'll find this trends tab in all your home, notifications, discover, and me tabs. So if we click discover right now, we'll see the trends is still there. So trends are determined by an algorithm that are based on your location and the relevancy of the topic to your Twitter account. You can easily tailor them to be to suit your preferences. So I currently do have them tailored. You can change that by location. So if I wanted trends from Rio de Janeiro, which is where I'm currently located, I just select that and click done. It's now giving me Rio de Janeiro trends. Once again, if you're in New York, simply click New York. And you will find New York trends. So to interact with these trends, simply click on them. Let's find the top one that's not promoted, failed apps. If I click on that, it takes me to the page that has categorized all tweets with the hashtag failed apps. As you can see, going down the page, all of these tweets have this hashtag there. And there are a lot of these tweets because it is a trending topic, which means it's the most talked about hashtag on Twitter at this moment. To participate in this hashtag or in this trend, simply click the tweet button, delete the tweet you already had in there, type the pound key, and type the hashtag that you want to participate in. Failed apps, then you can type your tweet here, you could add a photo, add a location, and simply tweet it. You will then appear within these results and you'll be more easily discoverable by other Twitter users. Okay, direct messages. If I go back to my homepage It's not necessary, but just, okay, that's not a good thing. Yeah, I'm just gonna try and get rid of that. Yeah, you're still there, aren't you? Okay, so I'm back on my homepage, and as you can see, there's a little icon up here with 179 on it. I think it's supposed to be a speakerphone type thing. I'm not entirely sure, but these are your direct messages. So let's click on that to open it up. Now, as you can tell by me having 179 of these messages, is the direct messages are used a lot of the time for spam. So people have automatically sent direct messages when somebody follows them that they don't even know they're sending out. It's sort of like a virus on their account. Such as this one. Hello users, thanks for following. Like our page on Facebook. Where users, I suppose, is supposed to be my username. And just simply trash that. But you do sometimes come across people who are genuinely interested in your account. This may be automated, maybe not. I found a lot of cool people who have been direct messaging me, and I've been direct messaging them. So it is a useful feature. Let me show you actually how to use that. Simply click new message, enter the person's name, and type your tweet. 140 characters is still the limit, but you can send as many as you like in a row.